RSV represents one of the main pathogens that causes lower respiratory tract infections in the first 2 years of life. Whereas in children older than 2 years, it is a frequent cause of upper respiratory tract infection. And if acquired in an elderly age, it can cause severe lower respiratory tract infection for the problem of immunosenescence. Anyway, the question on the importance of prevention of RSV infection is related to the link between RSV and asthma, as well as to the link between RSV and COPD. So the acquisition of RSV early in life with lower respiratory tract involvement is associated with an increased risk of asthma later in life, that means even with a follow-up of 18 years, and with the COPD in adult age. So this means that prevention is extremely important, but the importance of prevention is extremely relevant to in the first 6 months of life. In that period, of course, the possibility to administer a vaccine to a mother in order to produce neutralizing antibodies that pass the placenta and that can give a protection to young infants is extremely important, because in that way it is possible to avoid the infection in the first months of life. On the other hand, neonates and young infants have several limitations in terms of immune response against RSV. And so when they are vaccinated, if they are vaccinated at the end, in a large number of cases, they had an interference by antibodies of the mother, and this limits their possibility to respond to vaccination. The other possibility is to vaccinate infants starting from 6 months of age and then older children. But anyway, those finding studies are extremely important in this regard. Unfortunately, when we speak about RSV prevention, we have in our mind the problems in the 1960s with formalin inactivated vaccines that at the end caused an increase in severity of lung disease in vaccinated infants. This means that an RSV vaccine should be tested with in a large number of patients with a large data on safety. Safety is extremely important in this regard, and together with safety, it is extremely relevant to evaluate efficacy. So nowadays, there are several studies ongoing with different products covering different proteins. Regarding pregnant women, the ideal vaccines are those based on nanoparticles and on subunits, because these vaccines appear able to stimulate the immune response of the mother and to protect the infants. Now we should wait to studies on efficacy and on results in human beings, including pregnant women and young infants. In children, starting from the age of 2 years, we can say that the live attenuated vaccines, together with the vaccines based on viral vectors, could represent an interesting opportunity. Whereas in younger children, vaccines based on viral vectors and those based on nanoparticles represent the best opportunity in order to obtain a significant immune response.